That's coming. Good morning and how are you today?
I am fine.
Marvellous. Let me just sort this out. Oh. Loads of bottles, it's not booze. It's not booze, is it? It's not booze in your back.
No, it's deodorant. Right, see you. Right, okay.
So have we done our reflection following last time?
Yeah.
So what's the plan?
Well, I did parking and turning the road last time.
Yep.
I give 8s for both of them.
Excellent.
Because, like, I wasn't that confident with bay parking as I should be. Like, I felt like I should be.
Yeah.
With mirrors and turn, like, I've got I can control the car what I want it to do.
Mm-hmm.
And I did that in the end, but still, I just don't know when to turn in or
okay.
I can't see it. It's weird.
It's one of those things, isn't it? So, I mean, what you ended up doing was just, well, it was guesswork, wasn't it?
Mm.
Which is what it is for most people when you can't see the lines. It's much easier when there's a car in the bay. Because you've got something to gauge against. Having said that, though, you got it bang on both times. It's something we'll go back to, but is there an aspect of it that's worrying you or that you think you need to do extra work on, or is it just practice?
I think it's just practice to get that right. I don't know.
Well, I mean, what we're going to do is we're pottering around the place. And we're going to get to the point now, really, where we're starting to be certainly able to drive pretty much anywhere we want, really. And if we spot a place where we can say, oh, here's a chance to do that, you know, let's have a go. For example, here, if it was reverse parking that was brewing, we'd just say, well, I tell you what, let's just pop one in here. And we'll drive around a bit, we'll find another one, let's try another one here. So we can just...
I could do this, actually, for reverse round, right?
It's,
or
you
is
can.
That too...
Well, it's a similar thing, but it's it doesn't help with the bay park, does it? Because it's the lines on the ground that's the problem, isn't it?
I know, but I haven't done...
Oh yeah, well, I mean, certainly we can do that. That's not an issue at all. We can also do it when we come back from a lesson. I mean, obviously today we'll be stopping over the other end because you've got to college, but
yeah.
Well, if we come back here, there's nothing to stop us driving around there and then reversing back around that corner.
Yeah.
So to be fair, you could get a right or a left, really at any point. But what's maybe more useful, just a thought here, which is why we're on about it, is to manoeuvre the car to do this, where I've put it, because this is going to be more useful to you because then you can be reversing into your drive, can't you?
Yeah.
That might work. So what's the plan for today?
Well, I've been looking through all this,
ticking
through it, haven't we? I can't find it though. Yeah. And I'm just going one by one now.
Okay. Well, they're all to do, so it doesn't... You know, the matrix at the front gives you a logical order, but the next one, busier junctions, is probably the next logical step for us anyway.
Yeah.
So thinking about that today, so what else we got? Oh, some roundabouts. Okay, so if we did...
Because there's a lot of loads of in
Pontus. Oh, there's tons, yeah.
So
what we could do is maybe just starting from here, just go down and do a couple of roundabouts and just start working out in slightly bigger and bigger circles, and then we're going to be taking in busier and busier junctions. What's the difference with the busier junctions, do you think?
I'll need to be setting off quicker
for
their speed and... More observations, mirror checks.
Okay. It's finding the gaps, isn't it? If you turn left, obviously you've just got the traffic from this way to worry about. If you're going right on the busier junctions, they tend to be on faster roads, so you've got, like you say, you've got to get away quicker. Is there anything in particular you need help with that, or do you just want to just have a go and see how we go with it?
I think I'll be fine, because when we did the crossroads, I tested it there when there were no one about.
Yeah.
And I think I could do it, yeah.
Well, we'll find out soon. Well, remember, I've got your back all the time. If it goes pear-shaped, I'll jump in.
Yeah.
And then what we'll do then is we'll just have a chat about, well, what we've learned from it. We're not going to have a chat about who's to blame or anything like that because we're practicing something new. So I've got your back, but if you feel like you need help, just shout up.
Yeah.
Anything else? So, yeah, round Pontefract. I mean, from here, we'll just do a little warm-up, trundle around some basic junctions and then just work out wider.
Oh, God.
Who's this here?
Oh, it's not that. Hello.
Hello.
Morning.
You all right?
Fine and dandy. How's you?
I'm not bad, not bad.
It's a shiny car.
Like it?
Yeah.
I'm joking, it's not, it's looped. I would like yours though.
You need a Renault Clio. Renault Clio you need, that's a hairdresser's car.
Claire's got one of those.
Righty ho. When you're comfy. Onwards and upwards.
Clean my glasses.
Normally have a
I'm not letting them watch me set off. No chance. Bye.
Off you go when you're ready. How's the theory going?
Really good.
Excellent.
I did a practice test, I got 42 I think, but that's still good.
Okay. So how long now before the...
Next Wednesday. I know. Hopefully I pass. If I don't then I'll cry.
You lie down in the darkened room with some booze.
I will.
When you go when you're ready.
So I'll bring that back on. Okay. Do I put it in gear first?
I don't know.
I haven't drove in ages. So leave me alone.
I never said a word. Never said a word. So if we go at the end of the road, turn right.
Okay.
Next, we'll get the theory out of the way next Wednesday, we'll get a test booked.
Yeah, straight away. Turn right?
Yes, please.
Because there's... Can I set off in seconds?
Well, let's try it, see what happens. And then left at the end of this road. So it worked because you were carrying a bit of momentum.
Mm. But I'll have to stop here because it's more busier.
That's right.
Well, I could have carried on actually.
Well, what you need to do is to sometimes just trundle up at a slightly slower speed to give yourself time to look. It's also complicated today because of the weather, isn't it? Mm. Can't see quite so far. That's a bit too warm, that, isn't it?
It's a bit hard, that, isn't it?
It makes life a bit more difficult, doesn't it? Because your view's limited. So what do you think you might do because of that? Follow the road ahead of the roundabout. In your general driving, do you think there's anything you would change?
So the third?
The second exit, yeah.
Oh, am I in gear?
You are.
But should I have stayed in third?
You might have got to go with it. You're on the cusp between second and third there, won't you?
Yeah. Was it this one? Straight ahead?
No, but this will do.
This was straight ahead, though.
No, this is to the right. But that's
okay. What straight ahead means?
Second exit. This one's the third.
Straight ahead's the second?
Yeah.
What's that mean?
Following the road ahead, so it's the one directly ahead of you.
Oh. Do you want me to turn around?
No, it's fine. We can go this way.
I'm confused now. It's okay. Going up.
Well, it's never an issue, really, even on test, because you're not being tested on your ability to follow directions, you're being tested on your ability to drive. Left at the crossroads, please.
Am I still in second? Yes, sir. Don't cry. I thought it was that one. That's okay. Crazy person driving, crossing the road.
Yeah, we need eyes in the back of our head. So the busier it is, possibly the steadier we approach to give ourselves time to have more of a look about. What's at the next road on the left, please?
Are should stop here.
And the thing about which gate you need to move away again, because we're stopped now, aren't we?
Yeah. Thank you.
There you go. Oh, job's a good one. Sorry, we'll just shake the rust off.
Am I on my side of the road? Can I get by?
You can.
Can I?
You can. Let's pull up and have a little review.
I've just done that then.
That's okay.
That was clear.
So if we have a look at the last couple of situations there, you replay that in your mind, is there anything you could have done different, you reckon?
Yeah.
Go on then, what?
I didn't know straight ahead to the second one.
Oh, don't worry about that, that's neither here nor there.
A guy, I knew a guy. He was crossing, but he was running, so it was fine. Mm.
So is there anything you could have done different in those situations that might have helped you? So the guy crossing the road, and the little one where we come up there, we've actually arrived there at the same time as the other car. Mm. So what you could do, if you think about it, is you could maybe either just ease off a bit to get there after him, or go a bit quicker to get there before him. If you arrive there at the same time, then you're squeezed. And what you're doing then is, you're dependent on him doing the right thing. Mm. Well, we've seen enough of people driving to know that they're not going to, are they?
Yeah.
So you're better off not being there the same time as him. So just by making little adjustments on the way, and you think, well, hang on a minute, let me try not to arrive there at the same time as that car, and then you never depend on anybody else. Does that make sense? We do seem a bit in hurry mode today.
Am I?
I don't know. Do you feel hyper today for some reason?
Right.
Or is it just because we've had a week off?
I've had a week off.
All right, then. Let's do a bit more driving and shake the roost off.
Yeah,
roost? Shake the roost off the rust.
Well, this is it.
It's a nice hill start, isn't
it? Yeah,
it
is. Nice. So I have to find it.
Just go with your gut feeling.
It's hard to see.
Difficult, isn't it, when the weather's like this?
Yeah.
How's that for a hill start?
Good, I think.
Mm. Super control. So because your view's limited, it's... Mm. You need to take perhaps a little bit more time over decisions.
Oh, I kept that in.
That's all right.
Fine, it's
still
fine.
Worked, okay.
I've done it. Where are we going?
Follow the road ahead. So here, assume they're not going to do it right.
Right, okay. But they did, it's fine.
It's another situation like the one we just had. See if you can time your approach so you don't arrive at the gap at the same time as the other car.
But they're there.
Okay.
They're stopped. Is it stopped or...?
That one has, but...
Is it? Oh, can I go by it?
You can.
Alright, I thought he was waiting for that.
Oh. Well, because the lights are on, you can see the engine's running as well because of the smoke, the exhaust smoke. There's a chance that he might do that, so you're right to be cautious. So again, similar situations here, try not to arrive at the gap at the same time as the car coming towards you. See the white one coming now?
Yeah.
See if you can time it so that you don't arrive next to the parked cars, next to them.
But he's...
Go on through. That's it. So by timing it, you've got it so that he's in the gap and then you can go through.
Would I have got done on my tester?
No.
Oh, this is a scary corner. See?
It's okay, but of course you've timed it so you haven't had to stop. That's the important stuff.
Yeah.
So again, we have priority there, but you decided you weren't having it.
Yeah.
Next one on the right, please.
Is that alright?
What do you reckon?
Yeah. This is the right, isn't it? Yeah?
It is.
This is the next one.
Right.
I feel like I'm not doing it right.
Look over her shoulder, didn't she, as we were going up there? So there's a possibility she may have been stepping in. We'll go left at the end of the road.
Left.
And think about your gear.
I could set off in there.
So this left. Time it's a yes, please. This time it's a stop. It's a so stop junction. So you have to stop. Yeah.
On the line.
There you go.
No one's there. Oh, there's a dog.
Let's go shaking the rust off now, getting all the lumps out.
Mm-hmm. Think I'm getting a little bit better.
Yeah.
From the start. Oh. Can I get by?
Because you've held back, he's gone and now you can. So it's all about timing.
That was fine.
That was lovely. Very nice.
I wouldn't have got done then, would I?
No, not at all.
I'm just keep on asking, I'm getting ready for my test already, and I'm past my theory.
Oh. And the roundabout, we'll turn the road to the left, please.
Right. You still always, you don't have to stop if there's no cars there.
Correct.
So it's just like a junction, but it's yeah. Like a mini roundabout. I kept my clutch in there.
Yeah. So, what can you do about that, do you think?
It's just going to have to stop.
Through, that's right. And I will take the first one on the left. Let's have a little review.
Okay. It's pulled here.
Yeah, this'll do fine. Just past this driveway.
It's past it.
That's fair, because we're not parking here, we're gonna be moving off again in a second. So how's that working?
Okay, yeah.
So we had the gear issue at the roundabout and then we got caught out with a car coming the other way. Is there anything you can do different there, do you think?
Maybe gone a little bit slower.
Maybe.
So I couldn't see really far ahead.
I mean that's the key, isn't it? It's sometimes it's the physical location, it's on a bend or it's this, other times it's visibility. I mean it's starting to burn off now, but first thing this morning the visibility you can probably only see about as far as that white van. So your approach speed needs to be a little bit steadier to give yourself more time to make the decisions. Mm. What it feels like, and there you go, you can tell me this, is that we're making the decision late on whether we're going to change gear or not, and it feels then like we're sort of drifting into the situation rather than being in control of the situation. Does that make sense? So how do you think you might do that different? Any idea?
With my gear changing?
Or just with the general driving in there. You look like you're tensing up as you're going into the situations rather than being in control of it, if that makes sense.
It's been a whole week.
All right then.
Oh no, I do need to start always changing gears instead of keeping it in one.
Well, I think there's sometimes that you don't need to, isn't it? But it's, I think if you consider the gear, so you're thinking about which gear am I going to use here, and then it's like, no, I'm okay in the gear I'm in, or no, I do need to change. So if you think about that maybe a little bit further back, not too far, just, I don't know, maybe another second or two earlier.
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
Should we try that and see how it works? Yeah. Off you go when you're ready. Do you want to try that on some quieter roads, or do you want to try that on some busier ones? Should we do the quiet ones first?
Yeah.
Okay, let's have a little loop around here and one, shake the rust off, two, try these extra stuff. Super clutch control, you know, it just is. You have such mastery of it, which is awesome. To the next, not this one, but the next road on the right.
Yeah.
So have a think about that, what we're talking about. When you're
so with the gears.
Okay, so mirror signal, position, speed, and then think about which gear you're going to use.
Second?
Yeah, go on then. And because you've got it done in plenty of time, now everything is dead easy.
Yeah. And was I more on their side of it?
Could another car have come down that way and got out easily?
I don't know.
I don't think so. You're alright. Left at the end of the road.
So my gear second, they
are
right.
Second just now, but as you get closer, you're probably going to end up slowing down a bit.
So
as you, once you've tucked the nose in, you're in the first and then you're ready to go.
Oh, it's come off.
That's okay. Next road on the left.
Well, I could have changed.
That's it, man. Just go with your gut feeling. You've got it right. But because you've got everything sorted out before you get to the corner, everything becomes easy.
Just need to get used to changing and, like...
That's good. I think the key thing, go with your good feeling. You're nearly always right. Mm. Left at the end of the road.
This is like that by one, isn't it?
It is.
There's no one there. Could have set up in second, couldn't
I? Maybe. First took it too. Left at the end of the road.
Left. Yes, okay. And I have to stop here, so I'll go into.
Excellent, well done.
Oh, I thought I was going into the curve.
See the van, so there's potential there. So you need to just make your approach speed dependent on what you can see, what you can't see.
So we go down. We'll go second? Left again.
Possibly.
Because, if I have to stop with the cars, I'll go down to first.
That's a nice attempt. Lovely. Left at the roundabout. Second's probably right for this one, though, isn't it?
Ah, no.
Good job.
No one there. And I shouldn't have kept it in.
Ah, that's okay, you got it. So okay. This time.
See, if I clip that in then.
Mm
hmm. I could have gone to first and second, couldn't I?
You could have done either there, actually. Either was fine. Left at the next turning. Let's do another loop, get a bit of practice. Mm-hmm. So again, you went for the gear at the right time, but then we left the clutch down.
Yeah, but I brought it back up.
You did.
But
you
if did. I did keep it in, I wouldn't have had that much control of the car because it had just gone, if you get me. I held. When I brought it up.
That gave you the hinge and slowed you down as well, didn't it?
Mm.
Good, good, good.
Is it that left? That right?
Yes.
So, second, did we say?
Yeah, let's try and see.
Make sure another car could go down.
There you go. Easy peasy. So it all becomes really measured and nice and smooth and flowing, which is what you're after. So that you're in control.
With this, because I'm staying at this side of the road because of that car there, that's fine.
But it is, it is.
Because there's no one about. If there's someone about, I'd move in one now. Yep.
Left it, yeah.
Their priority.
That's right.
First.
Yep.
It's coming up into a hill, isn't it?
It
you
is.
Need more power.
There you go. Next one on the left. Just starting to feel a bit more even pace.
Do you feel not that scared anymore?
Oh, I'm never scared.
Okay, okay. Because I see no one there, I can.
Yeah.
It's just
just go with the flow. You go with your gut feeling. You're nearly always right.
Mm-hmm. Oh, could have gone. Did I do this last time? Could have gone to second. Oh, I'm scared.
Left at the end of the road.
I am confident.
Don't worry about it. It's just. Occasionally, you get yourself in a tiz-wars, and it's nearly always when you start doubting yourself. When you just go with the flow, everything works fine. You know, go with your gut feeling, it works well, doesn't it?
Yeah.
So I think that's part of the deal, you know, it's learning to trust your gut feeling.
It's with my steering. It's not really, it's just, I don't know.
So everything seems a bit hurried today.
Does it?
It does. I don't know if is there something behind that? Are we feeling tense over something else? Left of the roundabout.
No, not really. Like.
So you're not normally a hurrier?
I'm not.
No. You always come across as quite cool and calm. Am I letting the car drift, are we?
Yes. taxes.
So I think we need to go for that gear change a bit earlier and then make sure we get the clutch.
I've been thinking gears.
So here we've got
I could have gone then, couldn't I?
Yeah, there's something making us hurry today. We need to investigate that. Think about which gear? That's beautifully done. So we've ended up close there because we've rushed into that situation where we didn't have the time and the space. Next road on the left. Let's have a little review.
Okay.
We'll have a chat about it and see if these girls are still having their fag. Now they've gone.
Oh, no. Where shall we go?
I'll let you decide.
Well, this is the most.
It's the prettiest hedge, so we'll stick with that.
This is the prettiest bit.
So we seem in hurry mode today. We're rushing. Bang, 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 bang.
I don't know.
It's sometimes it can be, you know, if you're tired, if you're not feeling well, if your mind's on something else, you know, if you've got something worrying you, that can affect these kind of things. Sometimes it's... There's the feeling, I think, that comes over sometimes that, right, it's time I started to drive like everybody else drives. Where everybody else hurries. And it's not helping. There's the several times already where we've rushed into situations and you've had a brake and we've got caught. One with car coming the other way, that one there where we brake across the car. If we'd come in there a little steadier, you'd have had loads of time to think, all right, I can do this, this and this, and then just smoothly go through. But hurrying into things, if you make a decision in a hurry, chances are it's going to be the wrong one. So if you create a little bit of space for yourself and just think, all right, I'll just pull back a little, just a couple of seconds earlier, and then you've got that, you know, like the last loop we did around there, how smooth was that? Everything just went bang, 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 bang. It's when you come to situations and we're hurrying, things start to get a bit. So I don't know,
I wasn't hurrying then.
How did we end up so close to the parked car then?
Because I could have gone. I was thinking to go, but then I thought, no, best not. So you didn't look.
Who had priority there?
Me? No. He was too far away.
You're going under his side of the road. So it's like the situation here. If we have to overtake that van, the traffic coming this way has priority over us.
Yeah, I know that.
So we have to give way to them. So what we did was we came in, made that decision late, and then braked. If we'd made that decision a bit earlier, you probably could have just glided up and then let him out of the way and then you just go through. Makes a lot less work for you. Does that make sense?
Yeah, but I wasn't going that fast.
No, no.
I was rushing because...
But how difficult was it to get away again?
No, because that's not fair, that, because it was... It was going fast. It's down a hill anyway.
Mm-hmm.
And it wasn't that much... I could see ahead, and I think I was going fine.
Okay.
I don't know, he said I could go up there in a second.
Mm-hmm.
That's been...
How difficult was it to get away from behind the parked car?
I didn't go first.
If you'd been further back, would that have made that easier?
Yeah.
How could you have stopped further back?
We'll go really, really slow then, but I don't know.
Not really, really slow, no. We don't have to go to extremes, but we need to take account of the situations around us. Our hurrying into that created that situation. So if we just ease back a little, it's going to give you more time to make those decisions. And also, of course, in that instance, the person coming the other way didn't do anything wrong, but sometimes they do. Sometimes, excuse me, that situation's reversed and we're coming along and we have priority and somebody else takes it. If you're at the right speed, you can just ease off and let them out of the way and think, well, it's just a good driver on a bad day, and then we can go through. That's what we think, isn't it, surely? Is that what everybody thinks? I don't know, does that make sense?
Yeah, like I did up there.
Yeah, yeah.
Because I knew it was a sharp bend anyway, so I slowed down.
So I think we always have to think, like here, there's the potential that there might just be somebody behind that van we haven't seen coming towards us. They have priority, so we need to take account of that. So by approaching at the speed where you could stop or go really comfortably, your options are open all the time.
Just thinking outside the box, really.
Expect the unexpected.
Yeah, that's perfect. That's
there you go. Should we have another bash? With that in mind, on you go when you're ready. Can you remember the loop now?
Yeah, I think so.
All right, I'll not give you the directions either. On you go.
I will slow down everything. Well, it's not about like slowing down, is it? Like
No, it's about making your speed suit the situation, I suppose, is more. Well, here's the sunshine, look. Hurrah.
Well, not this one, the next one, isn't it?
That's all.
Yeah, the sun is. It's, I told you, it always comes out when I'm driving.
Sunshine's on the righteous earth.
Is this right?
It is.
You scared me then. I knew it was. I did what you. I'm fine. I'm just talking to myself.
That's okay. As long as it helps, that's all that matters. How did that feel?
Why, what, was it bad?
Yeah, it was tremendous. It looked good. I just wondered how it felt.
All right.
Cool.
Well, why are you asking?
Because I'm curious to know. Everything in the right place.
Me?
Yeah, that was, everything worked just lovely at my last one coming uphill. It's again like here.
This is a bit tight, isn't it?
Isn't it just? So you've made your speed suit the situation.
Yeah.
Excellent.
That was really. Why have we got this pull? Oh, God. Let's concentrate on the road, don't I? Okay, I can go. No, I can't. Oh, no, I'm not that how, am I? Don't laugh at me.
As if I would do such a thing.
Laughing at me. God.
These puddles are getting worse, aren't they? And left at the end of the road.
Do you think I'm ready?
Ready for what?
Do you think I'm ready?
How do you mean?
Like to go on to busy junctions.
I don't know. It's... Do you think you are?
I know I can.
Oh, I know you can.
It's just a...
I think you're capable of anything you put your mind to.
Yeah.
But do you think there's stuff we need to sort out before we do that?
Do you think so? I don't know.
Well, we need to look at our routine on the run in the junctions, I think. So have a think about it here, have a think about the timing of things. Go for the gear change, maybe a little bit earlier. And then make sure you've got time to get that clutch back up.
Okay.
Now you've got the reins on, haven't you? And you can control what's happening. So how much different did that feel?
A lot better, actually.
Yeah, cool.
It's because I kept it down, didn't it?
So once you've got that routine off, Pat, then we can sort of apply it. So here, take your time, because we don't know yet.
Yeah. See, it is quite hard, that, isn't it?
Oh,
I'm not going to lie. That is weird. That's a sharp corner. It's not fair. There shouldn't park there.
Well, the highway code says you shouldn't park on a bend.
No. Like, here?
But people park outside the houses. And we've it to deal with, haven't we? Similar situation here.
Right.
We're going sort of into the unknown, so we have to go steady.
Yeah, this is where other people should slow down.
They should. Well, that's the same situation reversed, isn't it? So there's all sorts of factors to take into account when we're trundling around. And a lot of it is to do with the way other road users are behaving or have behaved.
So with this one...
So here we're fighting.
Yeah.
So if you have a look at it next time, keep an eye out for somebody coming, because they have priority. It's better if we can time it so we don't have to stop. Sometimes picking speed up, sometimes losing speed. We have to be careful when we're picking the speed up that we take account of the situation as well.
Is that the speed limit?
30 here, yeah.
Is that it, though? That side? Oh, all right. Okay. Where am I going?
We'll follow the road ahead.
Okay. So I have to be very wary, because people can...
That's a great way of describing it.
Yeah. People can be... pick on the learners.
People can do silly things.
Mm-hmm.
People tend to rush decisions sometimes. We don't want to be one of them people. Get to the end of the road. To the road on the left, please.
So with my gear changing, I'd want to go in first because I'd have to stop.
More than likely. But of course, you can hang fire here because as you get to the end, the view opens up. So once you get past this parked car, you can start thinking: is it second or is it first? So because of this here, it's probably going to be first. Of course, he's parked here, which is forcing this traffic onto our side of the road. And although we have priority, we still need to be sure. And the next road on the left. Road bends around to the left. Follow it around when we get to the end of the road to the road on the right. So.
So where am I going?
Round to the left and then right at the end of the road.
Oh, so we've gone in a circle. That's
yes.
Nice.
Indeed we have.
This is where I walk to come to town. Cut this bit. I can't see.
So what can you do about that?
Creep.
That's the one.
I'm good at that.
And then eventually you'll get
really
a view.
I can see.
There you go, excellent.
It's because I kept it down. It's fine. I can do it. Should I? No, why do...
Think about the gear.
Why?
Because we're coming up a hill that'd be nice. Because they remember what it was like to be a learner driver. So again, it's another one of those where we've sort of drifted in, ease back here, but start making decisions.
So then
earlier.
I don't have to stop, but then there's another car anyway.
So what will we do about that? There you go. Because you've had plenty of time, you've been able to sort it out. Nothing in a hurry.
I should do that somehow.
There you go.
I know, I just don't like doing it. I don't know why. It's easy to be fair. Right, okay then.
Second road to the left. This one's the first.
Yep.
Bum, 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 bum. Again, there's nearly always vehicles parked all over the place down here, so we've got to kind of plot our route through it.
Mm-hmm. Whose priority would that be? Because I was turning left, what if on my right wanted to come
left
down?
The roundabout. So anybody who's crossing our path should give way to us.
That's why I'm staying slow, because there's people walking as well.
Yeah, it's a potential for all sorts of things to happen, isn't it?
Yeah.
So again, remember, we're going on to somebody else's side of the road, so we need to make sure. Yeah. Left at the end of the road, please.
So, I could go down to second, because it's downhill anyway, if no one's there. I didn't do that. Oh, it's coming up to a hill, though.
No,
I don't know.
Let's pull up on the left, have a little review.
Oh, it's outside someone.
That'll do nicely. Here. So how's that working, the junction approach? Talk me through it.
I think I can do it.
Oh, I know you can do it. I've seen you do it loads of times. But we're not doing it today, are we? Quite the same.
No.
What's different?
I don't know what's different.
It looks the same again to me. Everything looks hurried. You look like you're rushing stuff and leaving everything at the last minute. It looks like you're not thinking about the junction until you're actually on it. Where before we've just glided up.
I don't know what's happened.
It doesn't matter. There's something different today. We just need to sort of reset. Because it looks like it's hurried. It may not be. All I can tell you is how it looks. But it just looks like we're making all the decisions. But instead of doing them over a period going in, it looks like they're all happening at the end. I mean, that might not be the case, but that's how it looks. So if I might make a suggestion, so we can see if we can try this. You start doing the thinking about it maybe a little further back.
I've been trying to do that, because that's what you said last time.
So the routine that we normally apply is mirror, signal, position, speed, gear. I don't know if maybe thinking about those in its component parts would help, or is there a different level of help you want from me? Is there anything else I can do to help? Or is it just a case of having a few goes at it and just...
I don't know, I can do it, it's just... I doubt myself, I'm like, oh, can I do something? And then it stresses me out. I should just be able to just do it and not worry about it.
Well, I think you can when you trust yourself. I think it's you know, what I've observed so far is that when if you don't go with your gut feeling, that's when it seems to go wrong. You know, like the pullaways and all the other bits, but when you're trusting yourself, it just goes bang and it just works. But that's easy to say and not always easy to do. But there's always points when we're learning to do something where we call them learning plateaus, or you call them whatever you want, where you reach maybe a little sticky point, or something you've been really good at suddenly isn't as good. That's just part of the process. And it's a case of sometimes it's just like just work your way through it and everything's all right, just keep doing it. Other times it's like, okay, let's have a little rethink about that. What we need to do is to find a way that works for you. That's part of my job, is to find out, well, hang on a minute.
Yeah.
Something's a bit different. What is it that's different? See if I can help you to find out what it is. All I can tell you really is the way that it looks to me. I can't really tell you what's going on inside of you. And this is the key thing. So in traditional instruction, we try and instruct you out of it. I'm not necessarily sure that's
I know what you're trying to tell me. You said it before. I thought I changed. Oh, I don't know. I have been trying. I don't know what's different.
Well, it just looks a bit hurried. I mean, whether that's the case or not. So we try another few and see if we can just think about things a bit further back and then see what that does. We can give it a go, can't we?
Yeah.
On you go when you're ready.
Okay.
How's the heated steering working for you?
It's actually really warm. Have you felt it? Feel that? I know.
It's on here. You turn it off if you want, but it's quite nice, isn't it?
Yeah.
On you go when you're ready.
Okay. My mirrors and everything's fine, isn't it? Like, yeah. Yeah, I came out slow then.
That was lovely. Lovely, lovely, lovely.
It's fine in second.
That's why. All you've got left to do is just here.
Yeah.
So sometimes a case of just doing it maybe even 10 foot further back can sort of just give you that even pace that you're looking for.
There's a bend coming up.
That's right. So what will you do about that?
Ease off a bit.
That's it. Now you're ready for anything now, aren't you?
Yeah.
So in relation to the speed that other drivers drive at, perhaps drivers where you've been a passenger, they don't come through this steady, do they?
No.
They're actually driving too
probably
fast.
Probably I'm looking at them too much, maybe.
Possibly.
Because I do always...
Well, you're interested in driving, so you watch people drive.
I'll be able to do it. That's fine. I've done it fine. It's fine.
There you go.
Yeah, I am always looking what they're doing. If they do it wrong, it's like you've done that wrong. Am I going left?
Yes, please. So mirror, signal, position... Speed, gear, clutch back up, you're now ready for anything.
Yeah.
And in reality, it isn't that much slower. It probably feels it,
I know, that's what I feel like, I'm going too slow.
Oh gosh, no. Left of the roundabout. Same gig.
I'm in second.
That's it. And you've got all the time in the world to do what you need to do.
The last time around here, I rushed in.
Little bit.
I get it, yeah.
Little bit. See, that from this side, I'm sat here thinking, wow, that looks like somebody absolutely in control of every aspect of it. Where before, I mean, it didn't make me go, but it's just like, oh, it's a bit lumpy. Everything's in order, yeah. Fantastic.
Like showing the
examiner?
Yeah.
Left at the end of the road.
Right, change it when I'm off around here. Maybe I should. Oh no, I thought I could do it.
Nearly. Once you get that, so you maybe you snicked it in the first.
Oh no.
So whatever we do, don't hurry.
Okay.
So that one there, where the situation changed at the last minute, didn't it, with the van blocking your view?
Yeah, I thought I could get away.
Maybe just snicked it in the first there?
Yeah.
But the approach was fabulous.
I wouldn't have failed on that one.
But you don't fail for stalling?
No, I'm about to do it.
What tends to happen is people stall and then they start worrying about it and they fail on something else.
Mm.
Next road on the left.
Right, I'm fine here, aren't I?
But again, you've had plenty of time to make that decision. That's the key thing, I think. I mean, I'm not saying you should take forever to make decisions, but you know, if you've given yourself the right amount of time to think about it, it's like here we've got priority.
Yeah, but it's hard for them to see as well.
That's right.
So
that's
really, right. Both have to be. Watch out.
And this is not hesitancy. This is, you know, this is fine. You're taking account of your situation. Because what we want to show them is that we're safe at all times.
If you feel safe, tell me. If you don't, then tell me.
I will.
It's fine.
I will.
But you already have told me you don't feel safe.
No, I never said that. Now, next road on the right this time. Let's take a change of scenery.
So.
Same routine, though.
So I can go. It's my priority to turn.
Well, he's waiting for you. In that situation, you both have priority. Right. It's a tricky one. So you should go around each other. Nobody will let you do that. So we do it that way. It's one of those things where you've got to wait and work out what's happening.
I'm in third. I should have gone to second, shouldn't I?
No, this is fine.
I've done it, though. It's fine.
At the end of this road, we'll take the road to the left. Mm-hmm. Odd shape, this one. Well, you're probably another junction.
Yeah, I used to live on top.
Ah.
See with the bus, but I can see under it, so it's fine.
Well done, excellent, good stuff. Left at the end of the road.
And I have to stop, so I'll go into my first
gear. Once you're at this sort of speed, first probably right, gives you the usable power coming out.
Should I wait till it's starting turning?
Yeah.
Because
what
you
made
don't
you
know
say
what
that?
My dad told me.
Well, he didn't look like he was going to go left, did he? So you're quite right to wait. Your instinct said, wait a minute.
Mm.
So, you know, you're right, absolutely. Good feeling, serving you well again.
The car wasn't telling me. Mm-hmm. He was telling me to change gear. Right, okay then.
So all of this has a lovely unhurried feel.
Yeah, I feel more better now.
Excellent. Follow the road ahead, at the roundabout, to the road on the left.
That's fine.
So we're shaking the rust off.
It's 30 down here.
It is.
That's my thing here. That doesn't look...
No. It's very quick, isn't it, how quickly 30 feels slow.
Yeah, right there. To be really careful, don't I? It's not...
So keep your eyes up though. Left at the roundabout.
Oh wow. Okay. I did, I was checking, what's going on about? I know them's got this.
I haven't, no.
So it's fine. No. Oh.
Fall the rubber head. Busted.
It came off, what are you on about?
I can't believe you.
Oh, there's a bird.
Fall the rubber head.
What if there's like a bird in the way? Can you move out of the way?
As long as you're not going to inconvenience or put anybody else at risk. The thing to do with birds on the road. Well done. Flash your lights at them. That normally scares them. Not them, the birds on the road.
Oh. What are you doing? It normally scares them, are you?
So, birds on the road, if you flash your lights, they fly off.
If it's like a dark road.
Even in the daylight. And it's preferable. And that's not necessarily because I don't want to hurt the birds, it's because I don't want to run the bird over, because the bird can damage your car.
Yeah.
Can create quite a bit of damage and all. So that feel through all those parked cars and stuff there. It feels like you're on top of the game. That you're managing the situation.
Can you tell me where I'm going, please?
Follow the road.
I don't know where I'm going. Okay. Yeah. One step ahead. Oh no, I should have gone a bit faster then, to be fair. But
well, you've got these here. You've got the crossroads where somebody could pull out in front of you.
Yeah, that's
what I was
thinking.
You've got the shop where people can cross the road. So I think your speed was about right. So remember, 30 is a maximum. It's not a target. So like here, 30 might be. So you would do what you've just done there and just notch a bit of speed off.
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to do.
30's okay here, but then when the parked cars are there, maybe not. Yeah.
So I'm in third.
Left at the end of the road, please.
I can change it last minute. Come
you
on.
Can?
Yeah.
So on that last little bit as you're steering around the corner, just drop the clutch, pop it perhaps in the first left. Easy here. So again, we're rushing here. Got to take, see, he's parked across the junction.
I saw it, I know that.
Wait though, we have priority, but what if somebody decides to come through? We've rushed into that situation. No, we'll go down this way instead. Go left at the end of this road. So the guy across the road has
this
forced the other traffic.
Yes,
it's a bad idea. The guy on the other side of the road has forced the traffic on our side of the road.
Right.
We're coming over a giveaway lane. So we
I saw no one was coming.
I'm still a bit quick.
Okay, that's a little very down there.
Left at the end of this road. Mm-hmm. Slightly busier junction this time?
Yeah. So I'd go in my first. Because it's quite up a hill. Oh no!
Nearly. The idea was right.
I've fallen out with this car. I could have gone on everything.
It was shaping up to catch that beautifully when you first did it. It's just this much different to the clutch pedal. In the next road on the left, please. Now, this is always an interesting road.
This one. Or speed bumps.
Well, it's not just that. It's the way that people park up here as well. Makes life interesting. Mm. Here it's forcing us onto somebody else's part of the road, and once you're in the gap,
it's 20.
It is
right. So this is ridiculous.
Well, now there's nowhere for you to go, is there?
No.
So if somebody came, what would you do?
I don't know.
You could could wait here and let them pop into that junction.
Yeah.
Or a little bit further over. Because there's nowhere for you to go. If there's a
car there now, so he's going to have to stop to like.
Well, he can see, but be sure he's going to stop. He's worked the situation out and held himself back. But that makes for a difficulty when people park that way. Because once you're in, nowhere to go. It's like, eh? Similarly, around this corner, you'll find a lot of parked cars on the left. We'll take once we're in the corner of the first road on the left, please.
Yeah, that's fine.
But again, once you're out.
Then right again?
Left at the end, yes. Oh. Yes, please. No, sorry, left and then left.
Left and then right.
Tricky situations, those. Then left at the end of this road.
Second's okay, isn't it? Unless I have to stop.
Yeah. Well, yeah. I mean, the thing is that this last bit, once you're tucked in, you can just snick it into first gear.
Yeah, it's better, like... Yeah, so you get this. I don't like it. What am I doing wrong?
So bring the clutch up a little bit more.
Chop more?
Just popped out of gear. That's it.
Oh, I thought it was in gear.
It just, you hadn't got it quite in, it just popped out of that when the clutch came on.
That's never happened before. What have I done to your car?
Nothing at all.
I'll be ready next week. I think I'll be ready next
week.
Fine. Yeah. Week off, it's not good for me, don't you think?
Well, it's worthwhile. We'll go left at the crossroads. Oh, and then find a convenient place to pull over on the left. I forgot to get in there, the time flies. Maybe get you to college.
We've got half hour. Pull up on the...
Anywhere down this road. Take it a bit further down if you want.
Can't park on them white lines.
Well, we've seen quite a few times today, haven't we, the way that people have parked that's caused us issues. So we have to think really about where we're parking. Is it going to cause people issues? So this guy here, he's parked on the side of the road from the junction and next to a bus stop.
Oh!
Aha!
Oh no, where am I parking?
Oh no! So parking a bit further down.
Here?
Yeah, anywhere down here, it's fine. You're not inconveniencing people. You're not causing an issue where somebody else could. Well, you're creating a potential for an accident to happen if you park opposite a junction. Like this guy that's at the bottom here, where that wagon's parked. He creates an issue for the traffic turning left. Because from where you're sat, you don't get a clear view to the left until you're actually almost out. So he's creating a potential for an accident there. So we need to be thinking about, and people don't, you know, they're just, I'm parking next to my house and that's it, or I'm parking next to where I'm dropping this van off. So it's worthwhile having to think about, was there anything contributing to hurry mode today?
Oh, I feel awful today.
Oh, don't worry about it.
I don't know why I'm like this.
Well, if you think about it, was that the right speed to go through there? Think about, like, when you're doing stuff at work and when you're doing stuff at college, occasionally you get a bad day, don't you? And sometimes there's no real reason for it. You're just having a bad day. Well, it's not a bad day, but some days are better than others. It's the same with driving. You know, some days you have good days, some days you have bad days. Well, it's... Let me show you. It's because it wasn't... See, that's all the way in. If it's just nearly in...
I didn't know what happened. I thought I was like, what?
Well, did you sort it out?
Yeah, I sorted it out just then.
Well, yeah, but who sorted it out?
You
but still.
I didn't know, I wouldn't have known.
You didn't panic though.
No.
You sorted it out. That's the main thing. If you'd panicked, then you've got an issue. But you didn't. You sorted the thing out. So it's like with everything in life, some days are better than others. The nice thing is, when things haven't, and these are the things that we learn from really, when it hasn't gone right. Because when it's gone right, you think, yeah, we're all right. When something's gone wrong, it's easy to go, ugh. But if you just think, well, hang on a minute, what caused that? Is it, you know, maybe you've not had a good night's sleep, maybe you're not feeling very well, maybe your mind's on something else, maybe it's because, you know, you've been watching other people driving, mentally you're thinking, oh, I need to get on with it like they do. You have to remember that they've got tons of experience that helps them to do that. It's, worst case scenario is, it's a little hiccup. Has anybody died?
No.
Anybody cried yet?
I nearly have.
All right, okay. Have we hit any other cars yet?
No.
Ah, well, you know, so.
Could be worse. Like, I'd never do that. Mm. Like, and I've got that much control that I'd never be able to let that happen, if you get me.
I think the key thing is to just look at it and think, all right, well, what can we learn from that? And in that way, if you get a day where something like this is happening again, you've probably then put a strategy in place for coping with it. Because if you get a day like today where it's not quite working the way you want it to, there's nothing wrong with what you've done, it's just not worked the way you wanted it to, and you've got a long journey to make, you may think, okay, I might maybe need to make some adjustments here, or I need to do this, or I need to do that, maybe I need to just sit down and hum, point and whatever before I drive. So it's every day is a school day, and it's all about learning from our experiences. So make that part of your reflection for next time. Next week, I'll turn the camera off before we talk about that.
Okay.